students, welcome for today's video lecture of maths. You know, yesterday we have started our new chapter number 6, decimal, and in previous lecture we have seen the 10th means what? Out of 10. Okay, when denominator is 10, suppose 1 upon 10, how to write this into the form of decimal? This is form of fraction, and we have learned try this into decimal, that is 0.1, and so on. When denominator is 10, okay. So today, in today's lecture, we will see 100th and 1000th. That is, when denominator is 100 and denominator is 1000, how to write those fractions into decimal, that we are going to learn today. Now see, observe this grid. There are total 100 small columns or 100 boxes in that grid. Okay, 100 column boxes are there, and out of 100, one box is shaded. You can observe, out of 100, one box is shaded. Okay, that means what? Out of 100, one box is shaded. So this is called 1 upon 100, that are 100th. Okay, so this 1 upon 100 can be written as 1 upon 100 can be written as 0.01. Understood? When it was 1 upon 10, how did I write 0.1? Now there is denominator 100. So when there is 1 upon 100, how to write into the decimal? 0.01. Means after decimal point there must be 2 digits, as there is only 1, so that 1 write, and before 1 put 0. Okay, now observe this second one grid. In this grid there are total 100 small boxes. So out of, there are total 100 small boxes, and out of 100, how many are shaded? 15 boxes are shaded. Okay, so out of 100, 15 boxes are shaded. So the fraction is 15 upon 100 or 1500th. Okay, 100th. So this 15 upon 100, how to write into the form of decimal? How to write? You know, after decimal point, as there is denominator 100 and in 100 there are 2 zeros. So here, while writing into the form of decimal, after 100 there must be 2 digits. See this number, are there 2 digits in the 15 here? Yeah. So here not need to write 0 like this. Here there was only single digit, and due to this 100 we want 2 digits after decimal point. So before 1 we put 0. Okay, but here already there are 2 digits, so that will come after decimal point, not need to put 0. So it is 0.15, that means 0.15. Okay, now observe this third one grid. It is also divided into total 100 small parts. Okay, it has also 100 boxes, small boxes. And out of 100, how many boxes are shaded? Observe, each strip is of 10. So 10, 20, and that's 7. Okay, 27. Out of 100, 27 boxes are shaded. So it is 27 upon 100. So how to write this 27 upon 100 in the form of decimal? Yes, same like this. After point, as due to this 100, due to these 2 zeros in the 100, after decimal point we want these 2 digits. So this, there are 2 digits in the 27, that will come after decimal point, and before decimal point 0.27. Understood? Now see here, if there are, so in this way, when there is the denominator 100, this we can write into the form of decimal. Now, if there are mixed fraction like this, 2 whole 25 upon 100 or 5 whole 32 upon 100 as we have seen yesterday in the case of 10. 27 whole 5 upon 100. So how to convert this into the form of decimal? As this 2 whole means 2 complete grids of 100 are shaded. As yesterday we have seen the strip of 10, right? So you have 2 whole 25 upon 100 means 2 complete grid of 100s are shaded. And next, in the third grid, out of 125 columns, 25 boxes are shaded. So this is the meaning of this. Okay? So how to write? Now see, let's first put decimal point. This 2 whole, no. First write that before decimal point. And after decimal point, now think about this. 25 upon 100. What will come? It's 25. Okay? Here also same. 5 whole. That means 5 will come before decimal point. That is 5 point. 32 upon 100 will come this way. 32. Okay? And 20, here see. 27 whole. 5 upon 100. So 27 will come before decimal point. Now see. 5 upon 100. In this way, there is only one digit here. So, only 5? No, it will come as 05. Understood? 27.05. So, in this way, we can convert the fractions having denominator 100 into the decimal. In this way, we can convert the fractions having denominator 100 into the form of decimal. Understood? So, now let's solve the practice 6.3, which is based on this concept. Watch carefully, open your textbook, page number 105, and write, solve these examples into notebook, okay? In the notebook. Now see, let us practice 6.3. See you. Question 1. See, what is question 1? How will you read the following? How will you read the following? So see. 0.03. Yesterday we have seen how to read the decimals. When we learn the concept of 10. And now see here. 0.03. This is the decimal. How to read that number before decimal point, right? As it is 0 point. And here we will write digit wise. This digit is 0 and this digit is 3. So 0.3. Here you have to write that 0. Otherwise, what we say when we read this number, we say directly 3. But while writing here, when it is given in the decimal, we have to write this 0 and 3. We have to say 3. We should not say 0.3. No, that's wrong. We have to say 0.03. Understood? Next here, 0 before decimal point 0, then point. What we are writing? How to read that? That we are writing here. 0 point. Now, there is 16 after decimal point. But while reading, we will not say 16, 0.16. No, that's wrong. We will say 0.16. Okay? 0.16. Remember, don't say 0.16. That is wrong. We have to say 0.16. Okay? Here, before decimal point, there is 7. 7 point, what will you say? 12? No. 1, 2. Okay? 7.12. Next, 9 point, 9.4. Okay? 9.94. Understood? In this way, we have to read the decimal numbers. See the second question. Write the decimal for the shaded part in each figure. Now see, these two grids are given. Yeah, that grid is divided into 100 small squares. And out of 100 small squares, some squares are shaded. So first we will write fraction, and then that fraction will convert into decimal. Now see first one. Total 100 parts are there. Total 100 small squares are there. And out of 100, how many are shaded? See, each column is of 10 small squares. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 complete strips are shaded. That means 5 times are 50. And then 3, 53. 53 small squares are shaded. So the fraction for this is 53 upon 100, right? 53 upon 100. So this can be written as 0.53. Okay. The next one. Again, same. How many are shaded? Total are 100. Total are 100. And how many shaded? 4 complete strips are shaded. That means 4 times are 40. And next 7. That is 47. Boxes are shaded. So this can be written as, after decimal point we want 2 digits, 0.47. Understood? Next question 3. You write below each other. Okay, don't write it this way. Express these fractions as decimals. 5 upon 100, 32 upon 100, 1 whole 7 upon 100, and 9 whole 24 upon 100. See this, 5 upon 100, how will you write this into the form of decimal? Put decimal point, and after decimal, as there is denominator 100 has two zeros, so after decimal point there must be two digits, as there is only one digit. So what we are going to do, put 10 before 5, so it will come 0.05, and before point there is no digit, means there is zero, so it can be read as 0.05. understood? Next, 32 upon 100. Now see, after decimal point, two digits you want. Here there are two digits, write them. After decimal point and before zero. 0.32. Here, 1 whole 7 upon 100. So how we have written 1 whole means 1.7 upon 100. That will become 0.7. Okay? 9.24. Understood? In this way, we can convert fractions into decimal. See question number 4. Now pause this video for some time and write this. After that, we will solve question number 4. Okay, now see question number 4 I will write here. It is also very easy, question 4. Question is, express these decimals as a fractions or mixed fractions. Okay, here decimal numbers are given and we have to write them into the form of fractions, common fraction. So whenever we are going to convert the decimals into the form of fraction, it will have denominator 100 or 1000 or 10,000 in this way. Now we are seeing 100, that means 2 digits after decimal point. So there will be obviously the denominator 100. Okay. So see here 0.06. 6 upon after decimal point 2 digits. So 100 will come. That is 600. How to write 600? Okay. The next. 53 write up, after decimal point 2 digits, so 100. Okay. Now you see 2.05. See 1.07, 9.24. How to write 9 whole 24 upon 100. You see same here. 2.05 is 2 whole 5 upon 100. Why 100 only? Because after decimal point, 2 digits are there. Okay. 5.47, that is 5 whole 47 upon 100. Understood? In this way, we can convert the decimals having two decimal places into the fraction. So this was about the 100. Same, we are going to learn about the next concept, 1000. So instead of 100, 10 will be more. Same, everything is same, just there will be 10 extra, that means one decimal place will increase. First decimal place which we have seen, 10th. Then we have seen the second, 100th. 10th means one decimal place. 100th means two decimal places. The next is 1000th, okay? 1000th means three decimal places. Okay, how? See you. I hope you have completed this. Pause videos in middle and you can write that. Now let's learn 1000. Thousand means having such a fraction having denominator 1000, 1000, okay? So same, everything is same, like 100 which we have seen. So directly we solve now, practice 6.4, it is same like this, practice 6.3. Just the denominator is 1000, means three decimal places, okay? See the first, we will learn along with this, practice 6.4. First question is, how will you read the following? How will you read? Means we have learned how to read the decimal places. See here, how to read. So before decimal point, what is there? 0. Let's write it 0. We will say 0 point, 0 point. After decimal point, there is 237. But will we say 237? No. What we are going to say? 237. Each digit we have to write independently. 237. 0.237, okay? How will you read? 431. 431, not 431, no, 431. Okay? Now this, before decimal point there is 70. So before decimal point, it is whole number, so we will write as it is, 70, not 70, 70. Point, after decimal point, we are going to write the each digit independently, separately. So 564, not 564, 564, 564. Understood? Next here, before decimal point, which number is there? 561, right? As it is, 561. And after this point, don't forget to write this point, 375. I write here 375. Okay. So in this way, we can read the decimal numbers. Then question second. See question second. They have given here blocks of blocks having 1000 small small cubes. And out of 1000, how many cubes are shaded? How many cubes are shaded here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Out of 1000, 5 cubes are shaded. Okay? So, this can be written as 5 out of 1000. So here we have to write decimal for this. Okay? So, how to write decimal now? See, when there was 100, after decimal point we wrote 2 digits. Okay? Means if there would have 5, then we put 1 0 before 5 to make 2 digits. Now, here in 1000, there are 3 zeros. So, as there is single digit, we write it here, and before 5 we will put 2 zeros. So that after decimal point we have now 3 digits, 1, 2, 3, 0, 0, 5. So this indicates when there are 3 digits after decimal point, it indicates that there is denominator 1000. And here before decimal point, 0.005. Okay. Secondly, out of 1000, this is block of 1000 small cubes. Out of 1000, 3 lines of 10 cubes are shaded, that is 30. So 30 upon 1000, it can be written as 030, means 0.030. See, there is 30, and before 30 we need to put 10 because there are 3 zeros in 1000. So after decimal point we want 3 digits. Okay. Question 3. Express these fractions as decimal. Express these fractions as decimal. Now see here, 8 upon 1000, this is fraction, common fraction of, we have to convert this into decimal. Okay, so 8 upon 1000 means 8000. Okay, so this will become 008, and after decimal point no any number means 0. So it is 8 upon 1000 is 0.008. okay. Second, 57 upon 1000. Now, due to this 1000, after decimal point, we want 3 digits, but there are only 2. So, we will put 0 before that. Okay? 0.57. Here, after decimal point, we want 3 digits, and there are 3. Okay? So, 237, and here 0. 3 upon 1000 again, 0.003. Understood? Then last question, question number 4. Pause this video, write these 3 questions. The next question number 4. Decimals are given, decimal numbers are given with the three decimal places, and we have to convert them into the fraction or mixed fraction. So even 0.007, B 3.062, C 7.008, and D 2.596. Okay, see now this 0.007. So, as there are 3 decimal places, so in the denominator there will be 1000, 100, and which number digit is there? 7. It is 7000th, okay, not 7000, it is 7000th, th. Then here 3.062, so see a 3 point means 3 whole, that can be written as this way, 3 whole, and 62 upon, after decimal point 3 digits, that means 1000. 62 upon 1000. Okay. Here also same 7 whole 8 upon 3 digits, so 3 zeros. 2 whole 596 upon 1000. So in this way we can write these decimals having 3 places into the common fractions. Okay, I hope you have understood this 100th and 1000. All the concepts are same, just decimal places were different because due to the denominator 10, 100 and 1000. Okay, when there is denominator 10, after decimal point there should be one digit. When there is denominator 100, after decimal point there should be two digits. And when there is denominator 1000, after decimal point there should be three digits. So accordingly we have solved that. Okay, so if you have any doubt in this, ask me immediately. Thank you and have a nice day.